everybody. I am The Babazelle and this is my channel. And today we are going to be reacting to a very interesting video. Shout outs to this follower who sent this to me. I was like, yo, I need to react to this. I just need to, okay? So apparently this woman is suing her mother because she's too black. Now, I've never seen this episode. This video came out on YouTube about 10 months ago and it's at about 1 million views, okay? So we're gonna watch this, I'm gonna react to this. I can't wait to see. Woman suing her mother because her mom is too black. That's what it says. Let's see.
Sandra Johnson is suing her mother, Elma Johnson, in the amount of $600. Ms. Johnson claims her mother caused her to lose wages and a boyfriend.
Oh, okay.
Ms. Johnson claims she should have been blamed for the plaintiff's lost wages.
Miss Sandra Johnson and Mr. Johnson, I take it you're relatives.
Yes.
You're suing each other. No, Miss Johnson is suing your mother for $600.
Yes, I am, Your Honor.
Are you bringing your mother to court?
Exactly. Why?
Your Honor, this woman.
Respect their grown woman. This woman. Who does she think she is? This is horrible already. Oh my God, like.
A living, you know what. I'm suing her today for
this woman.
Yes, this woman.
Referring to the defendant, Miss Annie Johnson, the
referring
one who gave birth to
mother.
You?
Yes.
That's what you refer to her?
Yes,
no,
this
for real.
Woman.
Well, I tell you what, you won't refer to her like that anymore in this court.
Thank you.
Okay, well, I'll refer to her as Miss Johnson if that's okay with you.
It's fine with me, but not this woman, babe. We don't play that here.
Yes.
She deserves much more respect than
yes.
that.
Yes.
Whether you realize it or not, she does. Okay, go on. Now you're going to refer to her as Miss Johnson since you don't want to say mom.
No, I can't call her mom. I don't feel connected to her.
Right. Oh. Tell me a story.
She showed up to my job in a place that she has no place to be in,
mm-hmm.
making a whole ruckus, and pretty much got me sent home on the day that I make the most amount of money, and now I lost $600. Not only that, I lost my life, the life that I have been creating for myself since I left her.
What?
I've been trying to get away from her ever since I was younger. Growing up with a mother like her, it's not easy.
Why?
Look at...
Wait, hold up.
Her. We don't look anything alike. Nothing. I don't even know.
Okay, stop. You told me to look at her. I'm gonna look at her.
Wait.
Now look at you.
Wait.
You don't look anything alike.
No.
Why? Why do you say that?
She has that dark skin.
Whoosh! What in the nigga is going on here? What? Oh! I really can't do. Like, how dare she speak like this? Like, on TV, in court, in front of her mom at that. Like, she got no remorse. That hurt me. She not even talking to me. Push a la fuego, a la fuego. Form un patelo multi soufflet, okay? Somebody need a smacker. Somebody just need a just bow. Just,
Lord help me. Jesus help me. Okay, she has that dark skin. So what? What do you have?
I have light skin.
And so mothers and daughters and families don't come in different shades?
Oh yeah, that's great. But I've realized growing up that people with that kind of skin has it a little bit harder. And you know, I worked really hard.
What?
Just to keep my life as easy as possible.
Oh my God.
Okay, you need to hurry up and explain yourself to me.
Yup.
Your Honor, growing up with a dark mother was so embarrassing. All of my friends were white. Everybody was white.
Where did you grow up?
The guys I dated were white.
Yo.
Where did you grow up?
My friends were white. Alabama.
Well.
And what? How old are you?
Your Honor, I'm 25 years old.
So what part of Alabama did you grow up in that all your friends were white?
Birmingham.
In Birmingham. And you're 25 years old.
Bruh.
Yeah.
Which means that was in, what, 1990-something you were born?
1990.
And all of your friends were white. Yes. So if you grew up in Birmingham, Alabama, and all your friends were white, you didn't grow up with your mother?
She was barely around. She was busy cleaning up after white people.
Ooh.
I didn't want to live that poor life.
Mrs. Johnson,
Jesus Christ.
When this child
this is so disrespectful.
Yes,
Your Honor.
What were you living?
We were living in Alabama, Your Honor, and I was cleaning houses for a living, Your Honor. And so we ended up living with different white families as I had my job there.
So that's why she said all her friends were white?
Yes, ma'am.
And she went to schools. She went to school in the area of the families. I mean, the families that you lived and worked for, she went to school there?
Yes, ma'am.
And do
yes,
you
ma'am.
Realize and understand why you were able to do that?
Yes, because she was poor and uneducated. And so
what?
I lived a life of struggling. And like
what?
I tried, once I got away from her, I tried my best not to live that kind of life.
So how'd you get away from her?
I earned enough money to get away from her, and I started dating this white guy whose family had a lot of money.
At what age?
16.
What?
And then you changed your life? I mean, you changed your identity.
Yes, I went to college. I got an education. All something right. that she does not have.
What?
You don't see
and is that her fault that she doesn't have an education?
Yes.
Why?
She's her own woman. I'm not her mother.
You say you went to college?
Yes.
You sound like an ignorant fool.
Yes.
It doesn't matter.
She does.
Coming up on Justice.
I'm happy she reading her fulfilled.
We're back with the case of Sarah Johnson, who is suing Elma Johnson for lost wages.
You don't sound like a college-educated woman.
You do not.
You didn't learn anything about history.
At all.
Did you take a history class?
Did you?
You didn't learn a doggone thing.
She did not.
Because if you don't understand why your mother was working where she was working and doing the kind of work that she did and did not get a college education, it's because you don't understand your history and what went on in America during her age, a woman in the 60s, or 60 and over.
Yup.
And you have the audacity to turn down your nose at her for doing
yep.
what she could to keep your
exactly.
nose alive and well.
Exactly.
I just don't live my life as a black person, so.
What you
think you are?
I live my life as a person of privilege.
You live your life as a lie. That's why. Because you said
what?
The man that you went to live with, his family was privileged, not you.
Exactly.
Well, that's the life so that I created for myself.
Somebody need to get her. Somebody need to get her before I get her. I'm getting upset. I'm getting mad. Like, who does she think she is? First of all, you don't even look white. If she skin bleaches, she need to do a little bit more skin bleaching than that. The fact that she said that she doesn't live her life like a black person. What are you? You look black. Your skin's black. What are you talking about? I don't understand people like this. This is self-hatred at its finest. Self-hatred at its finest. I can't deal. Humming calms me down, guys.
Okay. That's the life that I created for myself, and she ruined it.
So
she ruined that, and she ruined my relationship with everybody.
How did she ruin your life? And how did we get to this $600 claim?
Because, Your Honor, once I got enough money to get away from her, I moved away. I didn't give her my number. I didn't give her my address. I told her if I wanted to get in contact with her that I'd reach out to her. But no, she is stalking me. She showed up one day to a grocery store.
Oh, man, I feel so bad.
Stalking me down in the aisles, trying to talk to me in front of all these white people.
Got it, tibus and salad. Got it, lily. You want. Bro, I feel so bad for the mom. Like, this is so heartbreaking. I can't. There's really people out here like this? There's really black people out here like this? Oh my God, it's 2018. I really can't. Oh my God, I can't even imagine what the mom's feeling right now. Not only that, this girl is so disrespectful and she doesn't even care. Like, she's just going on and on and on and making shit worse for herself. Like, y'all, like, she's really going in.
She shows up to my job, causing a ruckus. And she's just at the door saying, oh, there's my daughter. I need something to say to my daughter, blah, blah, blah. And
what
I
was
see
your
her.
Job?
I'm a dancer.
What kind of dancer?
A burlesque dancer.
Burlesque dancer? College educated, that's the best you can do?
Yes, I'm still in grad school.
Oh, what you in grad school for?
Law.
Okay. Law. Who are you going to represent?
Yeah.
Myself.
Yeah, you're right. Just you.
Yeah.
Not too many people would hire you with your state secrets. So your mother is outside asking for you, not asking, but telling people that's my daughter and I want to see her.
Right, and she said that to my boss.
And?
And now he's asking me if that's my mom, and so of course I had to say no, because they can't have people like her in there.
What? You mean black people?
What?
You dancing at a burlesque club somewhere in Alabama that's still racist?
Listen,
and black people aren't allowed?
Your Honor, let me tell you something. My boyfriend found out that my mom was black, and he confronted me about it. And when I said no, I wasn't black, he put his hands on me.
Yeah.
And it's her fault. She came here to ruin me.
It's your fault because you've been living a lie. And you won't accept your heritage and your roots. And you
won't
acknowledge your mother as your mother. It's your fault.
Exactly.
You've been living a lie. And your lie got discovered.
Thank you.
It was totally unnecessary. If you knew who you were and you were so intelligent and so sensible, you wouldn't have to live a lie. I live a lie. And I have a college education.
That's great. She doesn't.
Oh, my goodness.
Jesus Christ.
Ms. Johnson, I feel your pain.
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so there is actually a part two to this video. Let me know if y'all want me to react to part two. But Jesus Christ, I cannot deal with how terrible this girl sounds. This girl is absolutely ignorant. Comment down below if you know anyone who's just like this girl or similar to this girl. Thankfully, I've never met anyone who's that bad or that ignorant or that rude. I hope I never ever come across someone like that, because that just shocked me. I feel some type of way. Wow, like, I am speechless. I feel bad. I feel so bad for the mom. But like I said, let me know if you guys want me to react to part two. Let me know down in the comment section how this made you feel. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'ma see y'all next time.